an outro.
Hello, and welcome to this instructional video from Sea Kayak Open. Today we're going to be looking at repairing the Skeg system on any current Northshore or Valley Sea Kayak. To begin with, you'll need three simple tools. The first is a 2.5mm Allen key. The second, a flat blade screwdriver. And the third, which may be necessary, a 3mm Allen key. If you run into trouble later on, you may also require a pair of needle nose pliers and a set of wire cutters. The Skeg system itself is made up of five relatively simple parts. The first is the Skeg button. The second is the Skeg slider tube. The third is the Skeg slider housing. The fourth is the wire itself that passes from the housing all the way through the boat and enters the Skeg blade. To begin with, you'll need your 2.5mm Allen key. We'll take that Allen key and insert it into the Skeg slider button. We rotate the grub screw anti-clockwise to release the Skeg slider button from both the wire and tube. And after a few turns, you should be able to remove the button entirely. As you can see, it's a relatively simple part, just a piece of plastic with a hole through it and a grub screw inserted in the top. Next, we'll see that the tube itself is completely free to move, and inside the tube is the wire. When we go down to the back of the boat, we'll be able to pull the Skeg blade all the way down to reveal the wire. Now you've revealed the Skeg blade, we can see that the wire terminates in the Skeg blade and is fixed in place using a flat head screw that passes all the way through the blade and bites into the wire. Now you'll need your flat blade screwdriver in order to release that screw and release the wire. At this point, you may be able to pull the wire straight from the blade. I can't do that, but that's just fine. The blade itself is actually just on a small pivot inside the boat. So if we lift the blade up, the whole thing comes out and we can pull the wire all the way through the boat. And now there are a variety of different methods we'll cover later on removing the wire from the blade if it's stuck. One of the main reasons you may want to change the wire on your Valley or Northshore Sea Kayak is that the wire has become kinked. This is what a kink will look like, and no matter what you do to this, you'll never be able to straighten it out perfectly again to allow it to flow smoothly back into the boat as you move the Skeg slider forward. And then we can take our new Skeg wire and insert it all the way into the blade until it passes through the little hole here and comes to a firm stop. Then we can take our flat blade screwdriver and tighten the screw back up until it bites directly into the Skeg wire, slightly splaying out the smaller wires it's made of. And then we know we've got a good tight grip. Now we can feed the wire back up through the boat until it arrives at the Skeg slider. As we reach the end of the wire, we should be able to hook the blade back onto its pivot so that we can set the height of the blade when we terminate the wire. We can tell that the wire is the correct length if, when it reaches the end of the Skeg slider, the blade is all the way up inside the boat. So the next step we need to take is to re-terminate the Skeg button onto the wire. So, we take our Skeg button, and you'll notice that the Skeg slider tube has a small hole drilled slightly away from the end of it. We need to make sure that the steel wire rope and the tube are lined up and that the hole is facing directly out. The grub screw in the Skeg slider button passes through this hole and bites directly into the steel wire rope. If this is misaligned, the grub screw will bite directly into the tube and will likely cause the tube to shatter. You should be able to feel that this is correct when it happens, and you'll feel it tightening into the steel wire rope. Don't be afraid to give it a couple of extra nips just to ensure that we're slightly splaying the end of the steel wire rope so that the grub screw grips it very well. We should now be able to slide the Skeg slider smoothly backwards and forwards, checking that the Skeg blade comes all the way out of the back of the boat. It's very easy for me to stand here and be able to demonstrate this process on a beautiful, brand new, shiny Northshore kayak, but you probably will be doing this on a boat that's spent many, many hundreds of hours on the sea, and things may not be as easy as I've just demonstrated. So what follows are some handy hints, some troubleshooting in order to get you from the start of the process to the end of the process when something doesn't quite go right. One of the most common problems we find when repairing the system is that the grub screw will be completely seized. We just can't turn it so that it comes out and releases the Skeg wire. This is generally because salt water has been inside that area and then dried out in the sun, leaving the salt deposits behind, which gums up the mechanism. Obviously, we can remove it through drilling or cutting away the whole thing, but before that, you may want to try soaking a piece of cotton wool in vinegar and then taping the vinegar cotton wool poultice all around this area to see if the acid of the vinegar will dissolve some of the alkali of the salt and allow you to turn the grub screw and release it. After we've fitted the new Skeg wire, we may find that the Skeg is running too freely or indeed too stiffly. One of the ways that we could sort out a stiff running Skeg wire is to use silicon spray. The other thing we may find is that the 2.5mm grub screw at the back of the Skeg slider housing is gripping too tightly on the outside of the tube into which the wire passes as it begins its journey through the boat. Taking your 2.5mm Allen key, we can adjust the tension on this tube to allow the wire to move more freely or less freely. If you're having trouble removing the wire from the blade and you've backed the screw off all of the way, this is where your pliers may come in useful. So we can just grab onto the wire and we can have a go at first twisting the blade to see if the wire will pop out. If that doesn't work, I recommend grabbing the wire as close to the blade as possible and then rotating the pliers along the length of the blade, which usually draws the wire out. If you choose to purchase your replacement Skeg wire from Sea Kayak Oban, you have two choices. You can specify the length and we will cut the wire for you before we send it out, or you can buy a generic 2.5-meter length, which you then trim yourself. If you choose to trim the wire yourself, then there are a couple of things to be aware of. We need to make sure that we make the cut as cleanly as possible. If the ends splay apart, as they are here, the wire will not pass back through the boat and you'll be unable to rethread and terminate the wire. Instead, we're looking for a perfectly clean cut. The way to get a clean cut is to take some electrician's tape, some PVC tape, and wrap it around the wire at the point at which you want to make the cut. We'll then take our cutters and cut through the electrician's tape as well as the steel wire rope.
It's important to make the cut as strongly and as quickly as you can in one fluid motion. When we remove the tape, we will find a clean cut.
If you're having trouble removing the Skeg slider button once you've unloosened the grub screw, you may have to also unloosen or remove entirely the four 3mm Allen key screws which hold in the Skeg slider housing. This is simply done by removing the four Allen key screws. A word of advice at this point, Valley North Shore tend to seal the end of the tube entering the slider box at this end with some silicon sealant. If you remove this piece entirely, you'll have to rip away that sealant. I would advise removing the front two screws and then just loosening off the rear screws in order that the whole housing can pivot slightly out of place, but we're not breaking the silicon sealant at the other end. This now allows the bar to come all the way out clear of the boat. Earlier Northshore and Valley boats may not look the same, but actually use a very similar system with all of the same parts. This is a Northshore Ocean 17-6 from 2014, and the Skeg slider bar is identical, the Skeg slider button is identical, and the wire is identical. It just doesn't have the Skeg slider housing. In this case, when you slide the Skeg slider, you'll see the wire is exposed. Now that's because the wire actually extends further into a housing which is behind the bulkhead here. So the entire wire is sliding. It's not fixed at this end, so you can remove this and pull the blade down exactly the same as we did earlier, and eventually the end of this wire will appear and you can pull it all the way through the boat. If we're out on a beach and we discover we've got a kinked Skeg wire and we're not carrying a spare with us, if we're lucky and we discover that the kink in the wire is a relatively smooth and gentle one and not an extreme kink like this, then what we may be able to do is to remove the wire entirely and turn it round so that the kinked end ends up at the Skeg slider end and the non-kinked end that was at the Skeg slider goes down into the Skeg blade. All of the parts you need to perform the repairs you've seen on your Valley or North Shore Sea Kayak are available from Sea Kayak Oban. Head to www.seakayakoban.com and then to the shop section and spare parts and repairs. You can always give us a call or drop us an email and we'll be happy to offer advice. We really hope this video has given you the confidence to have a go at repairing your Skeg system yourself, be it in your garden, in your garage, or even on the beach during an expedition. If you have any ideas for videos you'd like us to produce in the future to help you with your knowledge in sea kayaking, then please do let us know. We hope to see you on the water sometime.